Hello, welcome to the brief overview of redundant configuration update feature in CIMPLICITY. Previously, CIMPLICITY required the redundant servers to be restarted for large project configuration changes to take effect, which resulted in downtime. The existing dynamic mode functionality is not really suitable for performing bulk configuration changes during runtime, as it doesn't allow some changes like new device creation, new product options, etc. So the redundant configuration update, also known as RCU, is aimed at providing ability to the user to perform bulk project configuration changes during runtime on a redundant CIMPLICITY setup without impacting the production or downtime. It allows the users to make changes to project configuration on the primary server when it is either online or offline, and executes a specific sequence of steps to seamlessly synchronize the secondary server and the viewers with the new changes without any downtime to the production. Moreover, the entire RCU sequence is automated with the click of single button in the workbench during the runtime, providing simplified user experience. The redundant configuration update provides better performance than the existing dynamic mode functionality and allows users to perform changes beyond what dynamic mode allows today, like new device addition or class definitions, etc. Additionally, the RCU feature also provides improved IT security for the plant by eliminating the dependency on remote registry for starting or stopping remote projects. RCU also allows ease of configuration for server redundancy by providing tools to the user to test connectivity to secondary server via workbench. Overall, the RCU feature provides better redundant capabilities for CIMPLICITY. Let's go through a quick demo. Let's take a look at a use case of adding few points to the workbench using a script and performing redundant configuration update. We have a redundant setup with primary and secondary servers with the viewer in this configuration. Let's create 10 new points using a script. The script will create 10 new points with data type as real, initialized to a value of 20. The dynamic mode is set to false. Upon execution of the script, the points are created successfully in workbench. Now on the viewer, we can see that the newly added points show up as unavailable. Let's go back to primary server and initiate RCU operation using the button in the workbench toolbar. In order to perform RCU, the user needs to have dynamic configuration privileges and is prompted for credentials. Upon providing credentials, a warning message is displayed that shows that operation might take a while and is user okay to proceed or not. Upon user acknowledgement, the RCU sequence will start and will stop the primary first and then starts back while secondary assumes active role. Once primary is up, the secondary will be stopped and started back with primary assuming active role again. And all through this sequence, there is no loss of connectivity or downtime on the viewers. At the end of the sequence, primary, secondary, and viewers are all synchronized with latest changes and new points show up as available. Thank you.